out this beautiful home out here in the Heights. I'm talking, that's Shepherd and this is Durham. So like you're literally in the heart of the Heights, right? And yeah, let's go take a look at this. So this is for listed for sale and for lease. For sale, we're talking $675,000. And for lease, we're talking about $4,300 a month, but we're also talking about a very contemporary modern style, you know, 4-bedroom, 3.5 baths, about 3,550 square feet. And so, and you have your own gate. Obviously, you're gonna want to install a lock with this. But yeah, let's go ahead and take you through the front door. We got a grand front door. So like really nice, like I think these are like 8-foot doors, 10-foot doors. But yeah, so sorry guys, it's like super hot today. But as soon as we walk in, to the left is this nice sitting area for maybe a breakfast table. You got the pantry in front of you, and here's the kitchen. So as soon as you walk in, it's all kitchen and like minimal size living space, but love the interior, love the color scheme. It's interesting, I love the countertop. I don't know how the floor really matches with that, but you know. You got gas grills, you got the farm style sink, a super nice microwave. Maybe HPG likes this. And so as soon, like the kitchen shares a smaller living area, room to obviously mount a TV, maybe get some furniture in here, hit up High Fashion Homes, you feel me? And so downstairs also has this nice backyard space. So that's kind of cool. It's a little small. So the downstairs on this specific home is a little smaller, but it accommodates the kitchen perfectly in my opinion. Refrigerator would go right here, you know. You got the larger pantry, you know, your kids, they can get lost in the pantry, or I could get lost in that pantry, honestly. And so this is the garage. Garage is interesting. You got 2-car garage over here, gigantic. And then as soon as you come up here, there's a little storage closet. So lots of storage space, guys. You guys are gonna see how this 3,350 square feet is spread out in this house. And so I'm gonna show y'all this. This is like a coat closet. Then I'm gonna show y'all this half bath. It's kinda cool. Oh, toilet paper, let's go. Gonna take y'all upstairs. So that's it. This is the whole area once you walk in through that front door of the garage. This is it right here, right? So gonna take y'all to the second floor now. Really interesting layout. So as soon as we get up the steps, and it's a straight shot, right? Come straight up. And as soon as we get up, to the left is one of the guest bedrooms. To the right is the master. And I'm gonna take y'all into the master right now. I have to, because it's super spacious, super big, super wide. Lots of space here. Can easily fit a king size bed here. You got little peeking views of downtown in the distance. You got your own rooftop deck. My God. I'm gonna show you all this right now, why not? And so the only interesting thing is this rooftop deck has the air conditioners sitting on here. So I don't know how much noise that's gonna be if you're living in the master, but that's a good question for the owner and for the agent. I think this is a new build, so it smells like no one's ever lived here before. So it's a good question for the developer on how loud these ACs will be. But guys, check out this rooftop deck. Got some peeking views of downtown, you know what I'm saying? This is like your driveway, so you got sufficient space. You got guest parking all around there. That's my car right there, right? So super nice area for space in terms of parking. Man, I'm sweating, it's hot today, man. Houston heat's back. So this is the master bath. We got double sinks. I'm not gonna show too much of myself, you know, cause got that perspiration going. That's the laboratory. This is the shower. Shower looks a little small to me, to be honest, guys. I feel like I'm a big dude, and I feel like the shower is kind of small for me. So, you know, and I'm not that big either. So it's like, you know, you got the 6-foot garden tub We're gonna come over here. I'm gonna show you all the master closet. Master closet is average. I mean, we've seen some really excessive master closets recently, so maybe that's why I'm not as impressed with this, but I mean, it's still pretty nice. I mean, guys, this place smells brand new. Like, I don't think anyone's ever lived here before. I'm gonna confirm with it in the details. So guys, make sure you check the comments. Like, the comments is where I post all the helpful information on all these walkthroughs. So make sure you check that out. This is one of the guest bedrooms. It's huge for a guest bedroom, god dang. But right outside of it is our laundry closet. So the laundry, the washer and dryer will go on each side, and you got lots of nice storage space up here. So that's freaking awesome. Gonna come back over here. Guys, this is huge. This is huge for a guest bedroom. You can easily fit a king size. Queen, you'll have all the space in the world. And you got a bathroom connected, right? And you got like a nice linen closet. And this is on the same floor as the master, so this is like a mother-in-law suite. And then huge closet, lots of space here, right? Come over here, side to side. Elbows up, side to side, elbows. Okay, I'm being dumb. Going to the third floor. Workout, baby, we're here. So got up all the way up the steps, again, straight shot. To the left are two more bedrooms with a bathroom. To the right is like a game room area, right? You can easily mount a TV here, have your rooftop deck, nice little dry bar area. And this is your rooftop deck. Rooftop deck. This is the third floor. Rooftop deck. God. Look at the downtown views, baby. You got Shepherd right there. You got Durham right here. I mean, come on. You can't get a better location. And you're looking over on everybody on the second floor rooftop deck. Like, hey, what are y'all doing over here? Yo, it's spinning. I'm gonna go check. Okay, I have to hurry up because I really want to go see how noisy that air conditioner is. So let's go in. Let's check that out. Okay, so. Yo, let's go. Here. Can I hear it? I can hear it a little bit. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. It's a tough one. Honestly, it's if you're a heavy sleeper like me, it probably doesn't matter. But if you're a light sleeper, or if you hear a feather move, or your air, you hear stuff easily, then, you know. Anyway, I'm tired. This is another guest bedroom on the third floor. Brought y'all back to the third floor. Man, y'all making me work today, man. I'm showing y'all all the goods today. Oh, man. Dude, imagine having a guest bedroom in a townhome like this, and your view is downtown. Like, this could be an office. Let's check out the closet space. That's sufficient closet space for all my young people working corporate that want to buy a townhome and live in it and rent out the others to your boys. This is a prime one. And you're getting 4,300. Oh wow, look at this guest bath. So like, it's renting for 4,300. So if you buy it for 675K and then you rent it out for 4,300, man. And even the 4,300, right? You can split that up. Like, you can split it up into rents per bedroom. I know I have quite a bit of friends that are doing that, where they buy their own home or townhome and then they like rent out individual bedrooms. And for these bedrooms, you can charge more. Nice linen closet. So again, this is our other bedroom. This is our other bedroom. I showed you all four bedrooms, all 3.5 bathrooms. I'm out of breath because I ran downstairs to see if that AC was loud. But anyway, y'all, hit me up. Another Houston property guys walkthrough. Gonna take y'all out onto the deck in style. You know, just letting y'all know. Hope everyone's staying quarantined in. I'm practicing my social distancing by doing a lot more virtual tours and, you know, staying sanitized. And, you know, y'all be careful out there, man. And if anybody needs help, the real estate market's still moving. Thank God Harris County deemed us essential to the Houston economy. So we're here. Much love. Let's get it.